Alright guys, welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to show you the custom shooting modes that I use on my Canon 1DX and my Canon 5D Mark III. You can use them as a launching pad yourself for some of the custom shooting modes that you guys use. Maybe there's something that I've done that you'll like, maybe not, but I just thought I'd share it with you guys and see what you guys think. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and jump back over here to my custom mode 1. On both the 5D Mark III and the Canon 1DX. So custom shooting mode 1 is my primarily portrait shooting mode, so I have it set up to use aperture priority. And when I attach a lens in custom shooting mode 1, I start with the aperture wide open. So whatever lens I've got on there, it's gonna start wide open. In this case, on the 1DX, the 50mm 1.2, you'll see it starts wide open at 1.2. Same with the 85 1.2, it's gonna start 1.2. So I always like to start with the iris wide open for my shots and shrink it from there. So large difference, obviously, depending on what lens you've got attached, but that's how I shoot my portraits. I'll start wide open and adjust. I have the ISO on both of these cameras to be on auto. So in this case, on the 1DX and the 5D Mark III, it'll go all the way up to 25,000 by 600. I find that both of these cameras produce images at that speed of ISO that I can still clean up in Lightroom 4.1. They're fantastic low light cameras. So I go ahead and jump all the way up there, and I've taken some great shots with both of these cameras at that ISO, and I've been able to recover nicely. So the noise does not bug me that much. And that gives me a lot more room with my creativity, with my apertures and shutter speed and such. I use evaluative metering, and importantly, one shot. So both of these cameras for my portraitures start off at one shot. Now, on the 1DX, you'll see I've got a lot of buttons that I can play around with on the front of this camera. So I've got a multifunction 2 button and a depth of field preview button. And same with, you'll see it down here, when I go vertical, I've got the same button array. So the nice thing about this camera is when I press my depth of field preview button on this camera, I've got it set to change from AI servo, from one shot to AI servo, excuse me. So if I need to jump into AI servo for whatever reason, tracking something in my aperture priority mode, it's just a push of a button and I'm there. Boom, boom, boom. Same with the 5D Mark III. It doesn't have as many buttons to configure on the front, but I still do get one depth of field preview button right there that I can press. And in my custom shooting mode 1, when I press that depth of field button, you'll notice I go from one shot to AI servo. So again, that's very handy to be able to just be able to change that with the press of a button. On the 1DX, however, I've got a multifunction button too. That allows me to change what type of autofocus mode I'm using. So in aperture priority, I shoot with point selection. So I can go in and select from any one of the autofocus points, and I'm actually at the smaller point selection. When I press multifunction 2 on this, it takes me from my spot AF all the way over to auto AF. So when I hold that down, if I need to, I can go auto. I can pin that target on something and let the computer track it for me. I cannot do that on my 5D Mark III without coming here and changing the selection mode with the multifunction button. Bam, 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 bam. And go over and do that. So that's how I have that set up. Also, you'll notice that I have on all my cameras on the right side a memorized autofocus point. So I can just simply press in on the joystick no matter what mode I'm in. Press in on that joystick and it'll take me over to that memorized point. Press in on it again and it'll slam me back to the center. So that's my custom shooting mode 1. Custom shooting mode 2 on both of these cameras is my sports mode. So here you'll notice I start off fully manual. I shoot all my sports shots fully manual, but I'll start off at a shutter speed of 2000. Again, I start off with my iris wide open. So I'm at f1.2 and ISO on auto all the way up again to 25,000 by 600 again, because I don't have a problem with the noise that the ISO at that speed generates under most circumstances. I'm using evaluative metering again, Now you'll notice I'm going into my high speed mode on the 1DX. That is 12 frames a second when I'm shooting RAW, 14 if I'm gonna shoot JPEG sports, and on the 5D Mark III, that's 6 frames a second. But it, on default, I set it to RAW. The other thing you'll notice is I am on AI Servo. So custom shooting mode 2, sports, high shutter speed, and AI Servo, high frame rate of the camera selected. So now that I'm in AI Servo, on the 5D Mark III, again, when I press my depth of field, you'll notice it doesn't go from AI Servo to one shot. Well, what am I using it for? In this case, you'll notice that I start off in my sports modes with the AF expand. So I've got 8 autofocus selection points and I start with the center. When I press the depth of field button on this camera, it's gonna go from area surround to auto select. So now I can, again, pin that point on the target that I want with my selection, push that button, and watch the little autofocus points dance across the screen and track that figure that I'm tracking. On the 1DX, I have a couple more benefits because I have a couple more buttons. When I press depth of field on this, you'll notice it will go to one shot. Bam, bam, bam. But my Multifunction 2 is set up similar to my 5D Mark III, where I start off in expand. When I press that, jumps me over into auto. So now I'm in AI Servo, auto select, and I can take advantage of the 1DX's new ITR tracking feature. So I can track someone's face, track certain colors, and watch that thing dance around and track that subject that I have. The autofocus on the 1DX, while it's very, very similar to the 5D Mark III, it's just a step above it. I've actually got RGB metering on the 1DX, and it tracks and locks on in extremely low light, like a $7,000 camera should. So that is how I shoot my sports. That's custom shooting mode 2. Custom shooting mode 3, let's go ahead and jump over to 3 on both of these. This is my full manual. So full manual for landscapes, whatever it is, I'll use this custom shooting mode 3 pretty much 80 to 90% of the time because I like to have full manual control. It's very similar to custom shooting mode 2, except for I start with a slower shutter speed. So I'll start at about 500. I find that that's a good happy medium and I can adjust from there. Again, I start with my iris wide open, f1.2, and I leave ISO on auto because it does just fine for me in most circumstances. However, when I'm shooting landscapes, I will go in, dial that down to 100, adjust what I need to get that, you know, that perfect shot, or dial it to whatever ISO I need for that shot. Again, using evaluative metering, I'm using one shot, and I'm using single shot. I'm not shooting high speed anymore. Same thing, depth of field takes me into AI Servo on the 5D Mark III. Depth of field on my 1DX takes me into AI Servo, and Multifunction 2 takes me from my spot selection over to auto selection. Even though I would rarely use that in a landscape shot. In fully manual, I might be shooting some kind of landscape or something, and then some cool wildlife comes in the scene, and I don't want to have to go into the menus, adjust all my modes, or even pull up the quick menu with Q and adjust that. I want to just be able to tap a button on the front of the camera, lock on, track it, and fire my shots. So those are the custom shooting modes that I use. Custom shooting mode 1, again, aperture priority for portraits. Custom shooting mode 2 for sports. It's got a high shutter speed and a high frame rate, and it starts on AI Servo. And then custom shooting mode 3 is my 90% obviously full manual control of my camera. Pretty decent shutter speed at 1/500th of a second. Iris wide open, auto ISO, evaluative metering, one shot, and single shot. These are the custom shooting modes that I use on these cameras. That's how I have them configured. It works for 90% of what I shoot, and I find it extremely useful. Again, I have my 7D, which this is being shot on, configured very similar, except for it's got the depth of field button on the wrong side of the camera. Hopefully Canon will correct this with the 7D Mark II, but I have it set up exactly the same as I do these two cameras. So no matter which body I pick up, I know automatically what settings I have, where everything's at. When I press this button, this is the mode it's gonna take me in. And it's very, very useful, very, very handy for a variety of situations. Let me know what custom shooting modes you guys use and why you use them in the feedback. And again, no trolls. Have fun, keep shooting, make some great art.